Welcome back to Show Tales. Festive season is coming, so in this video I'm going to create a natural dewy festive look that will last all day long. So let's get started. For the primer, I am using Vow Aloe Vera Multipurpose Gel so that my makeup glides on evenly, lasts longer and doesn't look cakey. Now I'm going to use LA Girl Pro Orange Concealers for hyperpigmentations around my skin. Orange concealers work better on those with Indian skin tone or olive skin tones, as lighter concealers are normally too visible. They are great for hiding any purple shadows under the eyes and can be handy for veiling hyperpigmentation. For foundation, the most important thing to consider is the coverage level you are hoping to achieve. As I'm opting for a more natural approach, I will choose medium coverage foundation. Dabbing few dots of foundation on my T-zone, focusing on forehead, nose, cheeks and chin, and using Beauty Blender to blend it in. In this video, I'm going to use MAC Studio Fix Fluid NC42 in the shade for medium coverage foundation. Now that my foundation is applied, I'm ready to apply concealer. Focus on any areas you want to conceal under the eyes, around the nostrils, and any blemishes or dark spots. When it comes to covering up, it's important to dab, never drag. I am using MAC Pro Longwear Concealer in the shade NC35 in this video. For powder, I am using MAC Studio Fix Powder Plus in the shade NC42. Swipe a brush or velvet puff into your setting powder and tap it to remove any excess. You want to ensure it's evenly covered before you apply it to your complexion. Powder sets your makeup and locks it in place. Finishing powder smooths fine lines and blurs pores, creating an airbrushed finish. For the transition shade in my eyes, I'm going to use an eyeshadow blending brush. Choosing a transition shade suitable for my skin tone from the City Mini palette from Maybelline New York, and doing the transition shade back and forth like this. Palette is Maybelline New York Chili Brunch Neutrals, and it is suitable for creating any nude or daytime look. Now to further accentuate my eyes, I'm applying eyeshadow from Wet n Wild Nude Awakening Eyeshadow Palette to my eyelids. And the color I'm using, I'm going to show you in the next section of the video. to define the eyes further and enhance their shape, I'm going to use Maybelline New York Lasting Drama Gel Eyeliner. To define and enhance my eyelashes, I'm going to use Maybelline New York Lash Sensational Mascara. Now to define the eyebrow and to achieve the most natural looking approach, I'm going to use Etude House Drawing Eyebrow Pencil. Now I'm gonna highlight under my eyebrow area with an angled brush with the same Wet n Wild Nude Awakening palette. Define the lower lash lines of my eyes, I'm going to use Lakme Iconic Eye in the shade brown. Now for contouring, I am using an angled brush and focusing on the areas I want to create dimension. The secret behind the perfectly chiseled face is contouring. Contouring creates shadows and adds dimension to the face. Now using a brush, I'm applying blush to the apples of my cheeks to create a subtle natural looking flush, moving my brush in circular motions to blend as I go. Blush is used to add a flushed color to my cheeks. For a quick and easy application, a powder should be a go-to. For the lipstick also, I will keep the shade as natural as the rest of my makeup, and I'm gonna use Huda Beauty Spice Curl for my lipstick shade. Now to define my lips, I'm going to use the lip liner from MAC and the shade is Chestnut. Finally, to set everything up, I'm going to use MAC Prep and Prime Fix Plus. So this is my full and final look. Please give it a thumbs up if you like this look and want to give it a try. And stay tuned to Showtools for more such videos.